Myself, Dr. Sudhakar. I work as associate professor in Department of Information Science in CMR Institute of Technology. In today's session, we are going to emphasize more on the future aspects of you pursuing your career in information science and engineering. What are the achievements that has happened in CMRIT and where we actually stand, so that you get a clearer picture to know about with respect to CMRIT. With this note, I want to emphasize all of you, like if you have any kind of queries and you want to ask in the middle of us our discussion, you're always welcome. And in the meantime, we'll be having a question answer session at the end, most probably after half an hour or so. Whatever queries you have, we are here to discuss all of them. And related to whatsoever details you need regarding the curriculum and the placement or aspects, all those things, if you have any kind of queries, we request you to wait till the end, or if it is very it is with respect to the presentation, you are always welcome to ask that question. So hope this particular session will be helpful for you. In the meantime, I'll introduce to our head of the Department of Information Science, Dr. Srikanth Prabhu sir. So sir will be taking you to a walkthrough towards the achievements that we had in the ISA department. And in the meantime, what are the possibilities that you may have when you actually pursue a career in information science and engineering? And whatever queries, I repeat, whatever queries you have, we are here to address them. We are going to guide you in the right direction. Hope this session will be helpful for you. I hand out the session to Srikanth sir to speak about the branch as well as the achievements that we had at Information Science and Engineering Department. Sir.
Yeah. Okay, I'll be presenting, doing a small presentation. Are you guys able to see the presentation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so the theme of today's talk is Information Science and Engineering in Information Age. So I'm going to talk about what the department is about, and you know what kind of learning opportunity we are presenting at CMRIT. So you know, since we're very few people who have joined, I not only request you to listen to me as well as spread the word to your friends, relatives, or you know anybody, so that you know they don't miss out on this. So basically, you know, I'll start with the quote by Abraham Lincoln that best thing about the future is that it comes only one day at a time, right? So today is one day you can make up your mind, you know, whether to join here or you know it can probably decide. So one decision can change your future, and that will happen on one day, right? That's why it's very important. I was just telling about even one day, one decision makes a lot of difference. Okay, so the topics I'm covering is about the CMRIT, some general things, and then about the BE program in Information Science and Engineering, what you have accomplished in the department, student engagement, and admission process. So if you have more questions on admission process, Dr. Sudhakar will take them, you know, and you know you can either you know put certain things in the chat box beforehand, or we have enough time, we can discuss after the presentation as well. So basically, you know, CMRIT is part of a big group of educational institutions. So we have common founders who have started schools to you know engineering colleges as well as big universities and all that. And CMRIT itself is started in 2000, year 2000, and we have now finished 20 years, right? So and we are located at the IT park where most of the IT companies are close by, and we are probably one of the few institutions which are in this part of the Bangalore, whereas majority of the institutions are the other side. So this is very closely you know located to a lot of IT companies in this area. Then in terms of the vision, the idea is, you know, we want to, you know, get a good standing for institution. Just a day before yesterday, we got a ranking called area ranking. It is Atal ranking in innovation in academics or something. That area ranking we got, we are now between a 25th to 50th ranking among private institutions. So which is quite an achievement, and we have a strong program in innovation as well. So if you look at the journey, it started, the trust started in 1991, CMRIT started in 2000, and then for years we have been starting newer and newer programs. And as you know, every educational institute goes through certain amount of accreditation and ranking by government agencies. So we are the only institute in Bangalore which has got NAC A plus ranking. NAC is a accreditation which where they accredit a college saying it's a good college, and majority of good colleges would have got A ranking, whereas we have got A plus ranking, which very few institutions get. On top of that, you know, NBA is where departments are accredited, so we have all the departments are accredited by the NBA agency, and we also have this area rank, which is between 26th to 50th. As far as campus goes, it is a very compact campus with 7.63 acres, and the hostels are inside, you know, and with a bit of play area and all that. So reasonably good and compact and cozy campus, and hostel, canteen, and all, lot of good facilities are there. On top of that, you know, your information science is one among the six branches, so we'll be studying with many other engineering branches, as well as we have MBA, MCA program also located in this campus. So as far as BE goes, I mean, all of you are aware, it's a 4 years program with 8 semesters, and we are affiliated to VTU, which is one of the best universities, government universities in India. And we have really well experienced and highly qualified teachers with lot of many years of experience. They not only understand the subject, they know how to engage with the students, how to teach them so that the way they understand it. So, I mean, pretty much the same kind of information. And, you know, NBA is an agency which accredits every 3 or 5 years. So we have got repeatedly accredited. That means they have certified that this department does things like teaching, learning, and many others reasonably well. So, I mean, same kind of things we have put. And as a department, we had intake of 60 people. Now it has become 180 people. So now a lot of people ask a question, what is this information science, right? So quite a few people are familiar with the computer science, and some people are familiar with the IT. Like many institutions outside Karnataka will have these departments. Even NIT has this department, which is computer science or IT. We have a different spin on the department. We call it as information science and engineering, so which is, you know, closer to computer science and, you know, not far away from IT. Okay, are you all still there? So to set the context, you know, I'm giving the web generation, right? How the web technology has changed. In the web 1.0 generation, there are only websites, you know, static websites and things like that. You know, generally you can look at a company's website. Only a company can, you know, communicate with you by displaying certain information. That was web 1.0. That maybe when you were just still children, web 1.0 was there between 1995 to started 2002 2001. Mostly static web pages were there. The people couldn't interact with the website. Then came web 2.0, where not only, you know, people could start doing transactions, but people themselves can create content. In web 1.0, at most they can fill some forms and transactions, maximum they can do some transactions, but nothing beyond that. They don't decide what content it is. Whereas web 2.0, the people decided the content. They put the kinds of blogs on their own and all that. But still, you know, people had to look for you in the blog and, you know, see who you are and all that. The way you connected was very informal. Then later came Web 3.0 with social platform. Like we started with long back, if I remember right, something called MySpace, and then, you know, Orkut, and some of those were the first websites which were social platform. Now, and now everybody is aware of Facebook and WhatsApp and all that. So what has happened as a result that all of us use IT to communicate, we are all generating huge amount of information, right? Which is not only generated by company, but also by all of us. And the same information we are circulating repeatedly. So there is greater importance to information now compared to computing. Computing was how it started, the algorithm and all that. But computing is still relevant and important, but more important is information. That's why you keep hearing about data science and all that. And with the data, you can do AI, ML and all that. Without data, nothing you can do. For example, Google Map, if you don't have the data, it cannot direct you, even with the best algorithm. So information science gives more importance to information. So we have more projects and electives and all that, which are focused to related to information engineering, which may be organizing information, analyzing it, and things like that. So I have drawn a diagram to differentiate between computer science and information science. Where information complexity is higher, we can consider it's information science, and computation complexity is higher, it's computer science. And for certain applications, both are high, like deep learning will require a lot of computing as well as a lot of information, right? So this gives you the context. So 95% of the courses are same between information science and computer science, but 5% courses are different, and we are giving more interesting projects related to information management. Then in the department, we have defined these four domains, like big data analytics, information systems, intelligent devices and application, artificial intelligence and machine learning. All this you must have heard of. When it comes to intelligent devices and applications, we are looking at IoT devices. Why? Because sensors again generate a lot of data and information, and we want to look at the solution where IoT is there, cloud is there, then big data is there, machine learning is there, like that. So these are the kind of domains we are looking at. Similarly, we have centers of excellence in data-driven IoT, and you know, a lot of research work also happening. I have not put all the teachers' profiles, but many teachers have published a lot of patents and proposals and all that. You know, I didn't want to leave out anybody, so I didn't put anybody. But you can go and visit our website, and each of the teachers' profiles are there on the website. You can go to CMRIT, look at the department information science, and see who all are the teachers. Then the question is, what do we expect from students? You know, a lot of colleges, you know, they say, you know, teachers have to do all the work. I don't believe that. Unless students do the work, unless students are interested, you will not get any benefit. So these are the five things you should have to do well. You should have a personal vision. What do you want to be in life? Right? Maybe 5 years, 7 years, 10 years, 20 years, doesn't matter. You may change it later, but you should have some goal, right? You should be like, when you get out of the house, you may think you're going to a movie, right? So you start off like that. And in between, you may decide you would rather go to shopping mall, fine. But you start with a goal and a vision in mind. Then you work hard for it. Then what may happen when you work hard, you will have some setback here and there, something doesn't work. You know, somebody may be good in theory, but not in hands-on. Somebody may be good in hands-on, not theory, some in projects. So you'll get some setback. If you don't persevere, you give up and say, you know, this is all I can get. But if you persevere, keep trying, right? Every semester will improve. And there is value for the education only if you get better at it. Otherwise, what happens in most colleges, toppers will remain toppers, and the people who are average will remain average, and they don't get much value. So the idea is that in education, everybody improves from where they are, and they compete with themselves. Then the fourth thing is be optimistic, because when you try out, some hard things also, results will come. And then be honest, right? So when you are honest, not only with each other, but with yourself, okay, did I really put the effort? What should I really do so to succeed and all that? And then you will solve your own problems. So all kinds of learning opportunities are there. Like regular learning is like lectures, tutorials, then self-learning is there. We are introducing something new called workbook this year. Then you can do MOOCs, we give credit. Then we have active learning, projects, mini projects and internships. And on top of that, we have a IND cell, we have centers of excellences and the excellence, then external activities. You can participate in a research paper, you can contribute to patent, you can do creative things. You know, we are, the last couple of years, we were one of the institutes sent maximum number of teams to national hackathon, right? On top of that, we do two additional things. You know, one, where we think VTU curriculum is somewhat dated or lacking, we have a program called TYL, you know, tie your laces, where we train people on certain subjects which are probably yet to be covered by VTU early enough, right? TYL program is there. On that, we'll train you on soft skills, then English skills, attitude, aptitude, then technical skills like Python, data structures, algorithms, whichever for career we'll train you. And on top of that, we'll train you for higher studies like with gate level questions. So you need not think, okay, oh, this is a VTU college, you know, there are autonomous colleges are there, universities are there, IITs, NITs are there. Where we are bridging the gap with the IITs by using gate level questions and by other institutions, by we are having our own TYL proficiency thing so that your career is taken care of. You just have to work, follow the rules and do what we say. Then now, you know, all of you know that it is all online. So we are equipping our teachers to do digital teaching. So, you know, so now you can see a couple of teachers, they're writing things on a wireless tablet and you will get the same experience as, you know, a better experience than the physical class because that particular thing will be visible to you, whatever diagram or something on your PC itself with complete clarity. Then you can put questions on chat or whatever, right? And so we are making a very good job there. And on top of that, we have defined a digital teaching learning process. Two questions, batch after batch, students ask us, right? Like I worked 20, 25 years in the industry and last 10 years in academics. So I know students as employees, as well as I know students as students. Most of the time students say, you know, we cannot relate to what we are studying to real world. Second thing they say that, you know, we do not get enough hands-on. So we have made certain changes. So where we have clear sessions where we set objectives, why you have to study this subject. We explain in clarity, you know, the students get a feeling that why they are studying. So third semester, it will be like basic courses. Fifth semester will be like fundamental courses. And seventh semester will be more value-add type of courses. So there is a structure to the curriculum. We make sure students understand it. And after that, we also assess what kind of assessment material is there. Are there good quizzes and all that? Then we provide for self-assessment. You provide for some mini projects which are not graded so that you can take up some challenging project which will not appear in the grade card, but will give you some awards and recognition and all that. So we are doing a variety of things. Then, you know, we have some teachers who will look at the recordings, and we have some senior teachers will see whether the knowledge, right amount of knowledge is covered. Like that, we have a very well-defined process to ensure that your teachers are teaching well. Generally, what happens in many colleges, they simply ask students, is this teacher good? And so teachers are asked, are these students good, right? So many times they say both are good, but then students are not doing well. Now, in digital world, we have everything recorded. So we can really see how the teacher is teaching. And we can really see how the students are answering. And on top of that, some senior teacher will go and, you know, be present when students are presenting their learning or whatever. So we not only have, you know, feedback in a survey, we have everything recorded. So as a department, we have done reasonably well in placement, right? Nearly 80% have got placed. And then these are some of the companies which are coming. There are many other companies like Amazon and all routinely come, right? And we are very active in Government of India programs run by AICT. AICT is a nodal agency for technical institutions. And then we have done many guest lectures and quite a lot of things. And we also starting a very strong Industry Connect program, right? And we have plans to do more things in areas like Industry 4.0, cybersecurity, deep learning, and all that. A lot of rank holders are there in VTU. Quite a few rank holders are from our department, right? And many toppers are there. So you can see their pictures, right? And Smart India Hackathon 2019, you know, they participated and won also in their categories. Then there are many other achievements. You know, engineering students are many times a lot more active outside their studies, and they have to really find time to do studies, right? So there are enormous opportunities. Why we are doing? Because we want you to develop as individuals so that you can take leadership positions. You feel more confident to cope with life's challenges, right? That's also important, but you have to find time, make time, and make sure you meet all the goals. And quite a lot of, this is like Google Developer Group, where we had this thing, and Google I/O, like so many companies have, like Facebook I/O, like developer conference. So we are, you know, participating in all of that. And we have a dedicated IND cell, Innovation and Entrepreneurship cell. Then, you know, sports also, many people are active. Then, you know, lots of hobby projects, lots of serious projects, quite a lot of projects where students have actually built things. Then routinely we call guest lectures. For every course, there's a guest lecture. Every teacher, every student goes through some new MOOC courses so that they're updated with newer and newer knowledge. So we get knowledge from industry. We get knowledge by doing other courses, knowledge by attending conferences, writing papers, and doing patents and all kinds of things. Then we also have industry visits. You know, now with COVID, last few months, nothing has happened, but maybe next year it will again pick up. And we have clubs, like each department has a student club where, you know, we can do variety of activities. Then some students, in spite of all this, may feel a little bit low, right? Or they may have some grievances due to personal or social situation, you know, we help them. We have for every 20 students, there's a mentor, you know, whom they can turn to for anything. Like we help them if they don't know how to pay the fees, or, you know, they have some issue with some teacher or whatever. At the same time, we don't want it to be like a complaint box. We want students to have good relationship with their own teachers, rather than go behind the back end, you know, complain to mentors. But any grievance, we'll address that. And we have incubation center. Basically, you have some startup ideas. You can, while you graduate, you can have a startup, and then you can be an entrepreneur. You can file your own patents in your own name. Now, of course, you have to give some part to the institute, but the patent will be in your name, and you can decide whom to grant and what to do with. And we are collaborating with, you know, a lot of other agencies and, you know, like things like IEEE and so many clubs and all that. You know, we have annually a Kaltura festival. A lot of our students, you know, they can compete with the film stars in like fashion show and all that. They do a really professional job, and we do everything ourselves. Instead of paying a lot of money to outside people, everything is done by ourselves. So we have an IND cell I kept talking about, and a lot of work is being done here. Some work is for community, social groups, some is for industry, right? and Institute Innovation Council. Like we have some 50 entries from CMRIT, which are there at the national level, and they will select some few of them, and you know, they give awards. Then we have a very close tie-up with small and medium enterprises, and we have dedicated people who are driving these relationships, right? Compared to other colleges, they simply pay lip service to things like innovation, research, and all that. We are very serious about it, and when we ask teachers to do research, they are given dedicated time to do it. Same way for innovation or consulting or whatever, they are given less teaching work, and they are asked to do the certain activities by giving them time to do it. So then this is the E-Yantra, is a collaboration with IIT Bombay. It's a very prestigious one. Embedded technologies is an upcoming area, right? With IoT and all, you need that. Then we have a lot of professional body cells, and we are, you know, like research methodology is something, you know, like any other well-performing college. We have many workshops, you know, experts visiting, and a lot of people are very keen to engage with young students and all that, right? As we speak, somebody wants to talk to people now to motivate them. So many people are lining up to talk to the student of CMRIT. And then we have clubs to promote open source philosophy. And then lots of initiative with the community, not only around here, so to some villages we have adopted, and we are part of a initiative called Uttan Bharat, which the government of India pays for it. And you know, if a teacher says, you know, this much money is required to set up some, you know, backup power or something, then government awards that thing to us. We have things like solar trees on our campus. When you come here, you can see. Now, coming to admission process, we take people from CET, Comet K quota, and management quota. But for management quota, they should have given any one of the competitive exams, including JEE. They need not have been in the short list, but they should have given the exam. That means we want to make sure at least you should have studied and given a best shot, right? So these are the numbers, and you know, you can send me mail if you have any queries, right? So then, you know, we have rankings, you know, NIRF also we participate. And then in different surveys, right, we have been in the top. India Today, Business World, Education World, Time Survey, and all that. Okay, so that's all I had.
Thank you, sir.